Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is gonna be, I don't wanna call it like a story time because it's not necessarily a story. It's more of just kind of sharing an experience that I went through, but I don't know what else to call it. Anyways, I don't really know how else to explain what I'm trying to say, but I'm just going to be sharing, I guess like a story time experience of something that happened to me when I first found out I was pregnant. And I had an experience with being told that I was actually in fact not pregnant. And yeah, so I'll get into details, but if you guys wanna hear this story time, then just keep watching. Okay, so to start off, if you watched the video where I said that I found out I was pregnant, my whole story time on that or whatever you wanna call it, I found out I was pregnant when I was 5 weeks. So when you're that early in your pregnancy, you don't get an ultrasound yet because most of the time the baby or the fetus at that point is too small for you to be able to see it on an ultrasound, I think is why. So you usually wait until, I think it's 12 weeks if I'm not wrong. I don't know for sure. I'm not a doctor. I think it's 12 weeks. I could be totally off, but that's what my doctor wanted to wait until. So I thought I was pregnant at 5 weeks. I didn't have an OBGYN yet because it was a new thing for me. And like I said, most doctors don't start seeing you and start like the ultrasounds and all that stuff and the testing until I think you can start seeing an OB for it when you're 8 weeks and then they do the ultrasound at 12. I don't know, but that's how mine worked. Mine was like, okay, you can make an appointment, but let's make it when you're 8 weeks, you're a little bit further along, let's make sure that the pregnancy takes and everything like that. So basically I waited the first week out, just doing nothing, being pregnant, I don't know, going about my life. And then I remember I was 6 weeks pregnant, so I waited a week and I started to have really bad cramps. And I also started to get a little bit of spotting, just a little bit. And I've never been pregnant before. I was so nervous. So I called my mom. I called family members. I was like, I don't know what to do. Actually, no, I didn't call family members at this point because they didn't know yet. I called my mom because my mom knew. So I called my mom. I'm asking her, you know, I have cramps. I'm spotting. What do I do? Should I go see a doctor? Something wrong? Is this normal? Because I read online that at that point you could still have both. And it doesn't necessarily mean you're having like a miscarriage or that anything is wrong with the pregnancy. So I remember calling my mom and she didn't have any experience with this either. So she told me you just need to be safe. Go to the doctor, make sure everything's okay. So I remember calling my doctor and she told me that she was booked for the day, but she wanted me to go to the emergency room because she just wanted to be on the safe side. She hadn't seen me as a patient yet, so she didn't know my body, but she wanted to be on the safe side and she just wanted to make sure everything was okay. So she told me to go to the emergency room and just make sure that everything was okay and that this was normal and make sure everything was good with the baby. So I remember, I think it was like a Tuesday or a Wednesday. So my boyfriend was at work and my mom was at work and my friends were either at like work or school. I wasn't working at the time. So I remember going to the ER by myself. I mean, I told Matthew, who's my boyfriend and the baby's father, I remember telling Matthew that, you know, obviously like I have cramps, this is the situation, and he wanted to come with me, but I thought that everything was fine. So I just told him, no, stay at work. You know, if anything happens, of course, I'll call you right away and then come down here. But the doctor just wants me to go as a checkup. It's gonna be fine, don't worry about it. So that's why I went by myself. So I remember I was a little bit nervous when I was checking in. I remember the lady was asking me what my signs and symptoms were. And I remember telling her, I'm pregnant, I'm bleeding, I'm having cramps. Like I guess expected them to rush me to the back like right away in front of everybody else. And I remember she was just kind of calm and like, okay, well, have you had this symptom and that symptom? And I remember being kind of irritated with her, which I don't know why I was, but I was just kind of irritated. And I was thinking to myself, why are you asking me all these questions? Like, you obviously need to check me, just get me to the back. I didn't even care, honestly, what she was asking me. So they actually did take me back pretty quickly. I don't remember having to wait that long. So I go back into the room and the first thing they had me do was give like a urine sample, which is pretty standard. And then I think somebody came pretty quickly like to come and draw my blood. So once that happened, the doctor came in, asked me some of my signs and symptoms. And this hospital doesn't have an OBGYN and it doesn't have like a women's center or a maternity center. So it was just a standard hospital. The doctor, I mean, of course he's a doctor, he knows what he's doing, he's trained, but he wasn't super experienced when it comes to pregnancies or pregnant women or anything like that. So he just kind of asked me some questions, took my blood, and then said, okay, well, we're gonna have you wait. So I remember waiting forever for anything to progress. Once they took my blood, it was like they completely forgot about me. I think I waited like an hour because I do know I was there for like 4 hours total. So I waited like another hour, the doctor comes back, he's like, oh, we're gonna send you for an ultrasound just to make sure everything's okay. So they come and they wheel me over there and they had to do a transvaginal ultrasound, which if you've ever had one of those, they are so uncomfortable. It's basically an ultrasound that they do internally inside of you. So they get like this long probe stick thingy and they stick it up your vagina, and it acts as like the little, you know, little mouse thingy that they use for the ultrasound. I don't know what it's called, but normally you have the ultrasound like on top of your belly. Well, this one, because I was so early in my pregnancy, they had to do transvaginal, which was extremely uncomfortable, especially since I was already having cramps. It seemed to me at the time like she was taking forever, and that made me concerned because I'm like, okay, if the baby was there and healthy and everything was fine and everything was okay, then you wouldn't be taking so long. You would find her, get everything done. But she actually took a long time, which kind of put me a little bit on the edge of my seat. And I was just kind of like, okay, well, let's just wait and see what the doctor says. So keep in mind, this whole time I'm keeping my mom updated, I'm keeping Matthew updated, and that's pretty much the only people that really knew at the time. So I'm texting both of them like, okay, you know, I went and did my ultrasound. She kind of took a little bit of time, and they're both like, well, that's okay. You know, she's probably just making sure that she gets measurements or whatever it is she's looking for. So I remember I wait like another maybe 3 hours at this point, and I'm there for 4 hours at this point. So I go to a nurse and I'm like, hey, like, I know you guys are busy and I'm not trying to take time from anybody else who may need it, but I've been here for a really long time. I'm really nervous. And if you guys could please just give me my results, like, I would love to go home or do whatever needs to be done. So this is where like my story time gets a little bit more serious. So the doctor comes in, and he was a male. He had my results, and he was very, very nonchalant. So he comes in and he goes, so these are your HCG levels. All I know is it's the freaking pregnancy hormone that they test for, okay? So he comes in and he shows me the levels, and he goes, your levels are really high. They're through the roof. They're consistent with those of multiples. And that kind of like went through my head for a second. I'm like, consistent with multiples, what? So I'm like, okay, Matthew's a triplet. For anybody that doesn't know that, my boyfriend, the baby's father, is a triplet. So I'm there thinking like, oh my God, I'm about to have twins or triplets. Like, what is going on? So he shows me the levels, and you know, I'm sitting there, and then he goes, so yeah, so it's really weird because your levels are so high, but you're not pregnant. And I'm just kind of like, I'm looking at him like, what? Like, I remember this sadness just rushed through my body, and my heart dropped into my stomach, and I didn't feel good. I got kind of sweaty, and I'm just kind of looking at him like, I'm not pregnant. He's sitting here telling me how high my levels are. They're consistent with those of women who are carrying multiples, but I'm not pregnant. But basically, the way that he explained the blighted ovum, I don't know how to say it. So basically how he explained to me was that I had a miscarriage extremely early in my pregnancy, and that a fetus was never actually able to form, but I did form like the gestational sac, because they did pick one up when they did my ultrasound. I had a sac there, and I had I think he called it like a yolk or something like that. I'm sorry, I don't know what it's called, but he was picking something up the sac, but it was empty and he couldn't find the fetus. And so that's what made him think that I was not pregnant and that I did have this early miscarriage. And basically what he told me was I would just have to wait it out, that I was gonna get more spotting and more cramping, and that's why I was having the spotting and the cramping, because I was going through a miscarriage really early in the pregnancy. That basically I would have to just let my body have a miscarriage, and if assistance was needed, I would need to schedule something called a DNC, which I guess just goes in there and kind of like cleans everything out and removes that sac that I had. And just the way that he explained it was very cold, and he almost was like, he was just very nonchalant about it, as if I wouldn't have cared, and like almost as if like, oh, I'm giving you some type of relief, like you're not pregnant. And it just was like, it was just a terrible experience, him telling me that way. I was so happy the second that I found out I was pregnant. So for me to be told that I'm having this miscarriage was terrible. It was like, it's the worst news that I've ever heard in my life. I've never felt such a sadness before over anything. So basically he tells me this news, he gives me the piece of paper, and they discharge me from the hospital, and I'm walking out to my car, and I'm like, oh my God, I have to tell Matthew, and I don't know how I'm gonna do it. So I remember getting into my car and calling him at work, and I just broke down. I couldn't even explain what was going on. I just told him, you need to come see me. He had to meet me. He had to leave work in Anaheim, and I was at a hospital in Chino, because I couldn't even drive at this point. We actually, I think, ended up leaving my car there because I was just so devastated and so hurt and so sad. So he comes and I give him the paperwork. I'm trying to explain what the doctor told me. I'm trying to, you know, show him what's on the paper because it's hard for me to talk at this point. And we're both just sitting in the car and we just broke down. I told my mom, I explained everything to her. And I was Googling everything that I could about this because I still felt pregnant. But what I had read was that with this, you still do feel pregnant because I guess in a way you are, but you're experiencing miscarriage. I don't really know everything about it, but I remember reading some stories of women who said when you get an ultrasound at 6 weeks or even earlier, the chances are they're not gonna find the baby. It's just too small. And a lot of websites were saying to just wait a week or two, give it a couple weeks because the baby needs time to grow and then you'll be able to see it. So anyways, a week passes and I just couldn't wait to see a doctor. I had a doctor's appointment, I think, scheduled for, it was Friday, so I had a doctor's appointment scheduled for Monday. And I just couldn't do it. With the emotions going up and down of I'm pregnant, I'm not pregnant, I lost this baby, or, you know, whatever is going on to I'm having this baby. It was too much for me. Like, honestly, it's like, I feel so bad for anybody else who's experienced this or had, you know, a similar experience. It's just, I could not handle it anymore. So I remember telling Matthew, let's please just go to the emergency room, the next city over, because they have a maternity center. And this is where I'm actually gonna have my baby. And they have a maternity center, they'll know what they're doing. Like, I just wanna be checked again, please. Like, I can't take this. So we went on a Friday night and we sat in the emergency room and I pretty much just told them I'm having cramps and I'm pregnant, so can you guys please check me, because I just wanted to be checked right away. So we waited and they took me back to do blood work and all the standard tests, and my urine was still showing that I was pregnant and my levels were super, super high, through the roof again, like consistent with that of multiples, which kind of scared me a little bit. But the main thing I wanted to see was the ultrasound, and I wanted to make sure the baby was there and that everything was okay. So they took me back to do an ultrasound. Again, it was transvaginal. It was uncomfortable, but at this point, I didn't even care. I just wanted to see if that baby was there. I remember telling the nurse kind of like my story, my experience, you know, like they told me over at the other hospital that I'm not, and I'm, you know, looking for signs and this and that. So she was so nice, and she let me see the monitor. She showed me everything that she was seeing, and she was actually the one to tell me. So she was actually able to find my baby, which was like, it was the best moment of my life. She even printed out a little picture for me so I could see it, and there it was, like this tiny little thing, and it was my baby. I got really lucky because I know that even at 8 weeks or 9 weeks, it's still sometimes hard to see the baby because it is so small. So I'm obviously so grateful that I have my baby and she's healthy, and I can't wait to meet her, and I hope that everything goes smooth with my labor and my delivery. So yeah, that was my story time, my experience, whatever you want to call it. I don't really want to call it a story time, but I don't know what else to call it. Anyways, it was a little bit more serious for this channel, but I just felt like it was something that I wanted to share in case anybody had gone through something similar. And if you have, then feel free to reach out to me. You can message me on here or on Instagram, or I always link my email down below. If you need somebody to talk to or you have questions about anything, I don't know everything, but I'm sure I can help in some ways. Okay, I guess that's it for this video. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.